Hello and welcome back. So in this video we are going to learn about bioactive principles. Okay, so this is a topic from master's practical. Okay, MSc microbiology, you have this practical where you deal with the extraction of some bioactive principles from some herbs like say curcumin or turmeric, then pepper, black pepper or basil leaves, etc., etc., depending on what is available in your institute or in your college. Okay, so in this video we are going to learn about what is extraction and what are bioactive principles, and then we will move forward for the different extraction procedures which are used. Okay, so yes, let's start this video. So first, what is extraction? So extraction involves separation of medicinally active portions of plant or animal tissue from inactive or inert components by using selective solvent in standard extraction procedure. Okay, so what we do, we separate many medicinally active portions of a plant or animal tissue, okay, from inactive or inert components, and we use selective solvents for the standard extraction procedure. So there is solvent involved in which we extract, okay, extract the active, medicinally active portions. Then the products obtained by this way are relatively impure, okay, they are impure liquids or semi-solids or powdered, intended only for oral or external use. Okay, they are impure, right? Because when you try to extract medicinally active portions, it may happen that some other components may also get extracted into that solvent and they make it impure. So these are only used for oral or external use, and they can be in form of liquids, semi-solids or powders. Now, what are these bioactive principles? So bioactive principles, they are compounds that are extracted from plants and have effect on microorganisms, cell or tissue. Okay, they have effect on microorganisms, cells or tissue, thus bio word is used, and they are the active, medicinally active portions, so active principles, thus the term bioactive principles. Okay, so I hope both these terms are clear to you. Now, these crude extracts that we obtain, they should be standardized to attain the therapeutically desired portions and to eliminate their inert material by treating with a selective solvent which is known as menstruum. Okay, it is a solvent. Now the extract thus obtained may be ready for the use of medicinal agents in the form of tincture or fluid extracts. Okay, now the extract that we obtain that can be referred, which is ready to use, it is referred or it can be used in the form of tinctures or fluid extracts. Now it may be processed further and incorporated in any dosage form such as tablets or capsule, but it has to be treated, it has to be processed. You cannot just use the impure extract. Okay, so the extract can be further fractionated to isolate individual chemical entities. Now that depends how much you are able to process them and how much you are able to remove the impurities from them. Okay, so now moving towards the main part of our today's video, that is different extraction procedures. So we are going to discuss about maceration, infusion, decoction, dissection, percolation, succinate or hot continuous extraction, then aqueous alcoholic extraction by fermentation and sonication. So of these, the one which is mainly or mostly included in every college is succinate extraction, and even maceration is done. To introduce this topic, during introduction, maceration extraction procedure is shown, and then the succinate extraction is done. You also learn these in theory also. Okay, so you may get questions on what are the different extraction procedures. Write a short note on infusion or decoction. Write a short note on succinate extraction or sonication. Depending on what the question is, you need to answer properly and draw a diagram if possible. Okay, so now let's start with the first one. Okay, so sorry, then different forms of extraction. So decoctions, infusions, fluid extracts, tinctures, peculiar extracts, that is solid, semi-solid extracts and powder extract. These are the different forms in which you can get your extract. Okay, now sequential extraction. Now how solvents are used? If you have to use combination of solvent, then non-polar solvent like petroleum ether, then more polar form of solvent like ethyl acetate, and highly polar form that is methanol. Okay, so you can use or you can increase the polarity of your solvent, and you can start with non-polar, then more polar and highly polar solvents. Okay, yes. Now about the maceration. So first form of extraction procedure is maceration, where a whole or coarsely powdered crude drug is placed in a stoppered container with a solvent. Now allow this to stand at room temperature for at least 3 days with frequent agitation and strain the mixture. The mark or the damp solid material that remains on the sieve is pressed completely so that everything can be extracted, and this combined liquids are then clarified by filtration or decantation after standing. This is maceration. Okay. Now, advantages are low temperature facilitates intact extraction of bioactive principles. That means the temperature is low. So if a bioactive principle is sensitive to high temperatures, then it will not be damaged or lost. Okay. Then it is rapid and efficient, can be scaled up for large quantities, and bioactive principles are not degraded due to over agitation or high temperatures subjected during extraction. These are the advantages. This is the very simple extraction procedure. Okay, then disadvantages. So this is time consuming because you have to keep it for at least 3 days. Then it consumes large quantities of solvent, that is menstruum. Then compounds which require heat for efficient extraction, they cannot be dissolved in the menstruum by maceration. Okay, so this was about the first extraction procedure. Then the second one is infusion. Okay, infusion is similar to making tea, right? So fresh infusion are made by macerating the crude drug for a short period of time by exposing it to a cold or boiling water. So these are dilute solutions of readily soluble constituents of crude drug. Okay, so the constituents which are readily soluble in boiling water, they can be extracted easily by the process of infusion. Okay, so you can see here some herbs are placed in a container, glass container, and a hot boiling water is poured. So what will happen? The temperature will affect, or it will start reacting with the soluble constituents, and it will extract these infusions, these bioactive principles in the hot water. Okay, that is infusion. So the advantage is it is less time consumption. It has less time consumption than compounds that require heat can be extracted. Then disadvantages are complete extraction cannot be done. Heat labile compounds will be denatured. Volatile compounds will be lost. And constant temperatures cannot be maintained, okay, in infusion, right? Then next is digestion. So it is a form of maceration. Gentle heat is used during extraction procedure. Okay, then used when moderately evaluated temperatures are not objectionable. Okay, the solvent efficiency of the menstruum is increased. What is done here? It is a modified form of maceration, the first extraction procedure that we studied. Okay, what is done here? What is different in digestion and maceration? A gentle heat is provided. Okay, so you can see here a gentle heat is provided by a heater, and this is the round bottom flask in which your solvent and the drug or the bioactive principle that has to be extracted from a herb that is placed. Okay, so a gentle heat is provided and it is evaluated. Okay, moderate temperature should be given. Now the solvent efficiency of the menstruum is increased here as compared to the maceration. Okay, so what are the advantages? The solvent efficiency of the menstruum is increased. Then constant temperatures can be provided as we are using a heater here. Then it ensures extraction of compounds that require evaluated temperatures, like till 60 degree temperature is tolerated by the drug, or it can be easily used for 60 degrees Celsius. Those kind of drugs can be extracted by using digestion. Then the disadvantage is heat labile compounds will get denatured, and energy consumption is here, so it will cost extra. Then fourth one is decoction. So in this process, a crude drug is boiled in a specified volume of water for a defined time. It is then cooled and strained or filtered. Same as tea, process of making tea, right? We add tea powder or tea leaves in water and we boil it for a defined period of time. We add sugar or milk and then we strain it and we consume it. Okay, so that is kind of a decoction. So this procedure is suitable for extracting water-soluble, heat-stable constituents. Okay, this process is typically used for preparation of Ayurvedic extracts like kwath or kwatha. The starting ratio of crude drug to water is fixed, that is 1:1:4. That is, the crude drug should be of 1 portion and 4 parts of water, or 1:16. The volume is then brought down to the 1/4 of its original volume by boiling during the extraction procedures. Then the concentrated extract is filtered and is used as it is processed further. That depends on what kind of drug it is and what or how much it is to be used. Okay, depending on the dosage, you can consider whether to process it further or not. Then comes percolation. Okay, so this is the procedure used most frequently for the extraction of active ingredients in the preparation of tinctures or fluid extracts. Okay, a percolator, it is actually a narrow cone-shaped vessel open at the bottom end, and it is generally used for the process of percolation. Now the solid ingredients are moistened and with an appropriate amount of specified menstruum, and they are allowed to stand for approximately 4 hours in a well closed container, after which the mass of packed and the top of the percolator is closed. Okay, the mass is packed and the top of the percolator is closed. The additional menstruum is added to form a shallow layer above the mass, and the mixture is allowed to macerate in the closed percolator for 4 hours. Now you can add the menstruum here from this part as slowly, so that it should form a layer above the mass and it should percolate. That means it should drip from your mass. So when it flows from your mass of your drug or your herb, what will happen? The solvent will start extracting the bioactive principles and it will settle down and you can extract. Okay, that's how the percolation works. The outlet of the percolator then is opened and the liquid contained within is allowed to drip slowly. Now additional menstruum is added as required until the percolate measures about the 3/4 of the required volume to the finished product. The mug is then pressed and the expressed liquid is added to the percolate. Sufficient menstruum is added to produce the required volume and the mixed liquid is clarified by filtration or by standing, followed by the decantation. Okay, so this is quite lengthy, I know, but at least try to understand the process and you can write it in short in your exams. Okay, then next comes the very important salicylate extraction, which is also known as hot continuous extraction. So in this method, a finely ground crude drug is placed in a porous bag, or it is known as thimble, a bag made up of a mesh like cloth. Okay, and it is made of strong filter paper, or also you can make it of a filter paper, which is then placed in the chamber E, extraction chamber. So this is where you place your sample in the salicylate apparatus. The extracting solvent in flask A is heated and its vapor condensed in the condenser. So this is the flask where the extracting solvent is placed. It is heated. So when it is heated, the vapors will start condensing in the condenser. So these are the inlet and outlet valves from where the tubings are attached if the cooling or heating is required. Okay, so the condensed extract or extractant, it drips into the thimble containing the crude drug. Okay, so now the condensed solvent, it starts dripping into the sample. Okay, over the thimble which contains the crude drug, and it starts extracting the bioactive principles as it comes in contact. Okay, so when the level of the liquid in chamber E, so as the level rises here, okay, to this opening, what happens? The solvent with the bioactive principles, it will go down through this siphon. Okay, the level of liquid in the chamber E rises to the top of siphon tube C. The liquid contains of chamber E siphons into the flask A again. Okay, so now your solvent is back into your flask. This process is continuous and is carried out until a drop of solvent from the siphon tube or siphon tube does not leave residue when evaporated. The advantage of this method compared to the previously described methods is that large amount of drug can be extracted with a much smaller quantity of solvent. Okay, this affects tremendous economy in terms of time, energy and consequently financial inputs. At small scales it is employed as a batch process only, but it becomes much more economical and viable when converted into continuous extraction procedure on large or medium scale. Okay, so this is one of the examples which can be used continuously for extraction of large quantities of drug. Okay, then comes the aqueous alcoholic extraction by fermentation. So some medicinal preparations of Ayurveda like Asava or Arista, they adopt the technique of fermentation. Okay, for extracting these active principles. Now, extraction procedure involves soaking of crude drug in form of either a powder or decoction. Okay, for a specified period of time during which it undergoes fermentation. Now, why this is beneficial? Because fermentation generates alcohol in situ. Okay, and this facilitates the extraction of active constituent contained in the plant material itself. Now, the alcohol thus generated also serves a preservative, and if the fermentation is to be carried out in an earthen vessel, then it should not be new. Water should be filled first in it and it should be boiled, okay, so that it can be used. Otherwise, in large-scale manufacturing processes, what is done? Wooden vats, porcelain jars or metal vessels, they are used in place of earthen vessels. Okay, so some examples of the preparations are Karpurasava, Kanakasava and Dasmularista. Okay, so this is about aqueous alcoholic extraction. Okay, so the last one here, that is sonication. So starting from a very cost effective method, that is maceration till sonication, we are covering all these processes where sonication is in higher cost. Okay, it cost too much. Okay, so this is the last method which is listed at the bottom, and you can see how these extraction processes are different from one another, what are their advantages, what are their disadvantages. Everything is covered here. So I hope you are able to now write your answers and score good. Okay, so let's cover the last one here, that is sonication, which is also known as ultrasound extraction. So this procedure involves use of ultrasound frequencies which are ranging from 20 kilohertz to 2000 kilohertz. Now how these are used? Now these ultrasound frequencies, they increase the permeability of the cell walls and they produce cavitation. Okay, and this is how the bioactive principles, they are extracted. Okay, now although this process is useful in some cases like in extraction of Rowolfia roots, its large scale application is limited due to the higher cost. Okay, so disadvantage. Now another disadvantage is it has some deleterious effect of ultrasound energy on the active constituents of medicinal plants through the formation of free radicals, and consequently undesirable changes in the drug molecules can be seen. Okay, so this was about sonication, and yes, I have covered all the 8 different extraction procedures in this video. So I hope this video is helpful to you all. Thank you for watching my video. Do give a thumbs up, do like my video, do share these videos with your friends, do subscribe to my channel and keep supporting. Thank you.